I'm going to look at linear programming with this system of inequalities, this constraint function. We're looking for a maximum value of this function for points that are true for these inequalities. And to do this, I want to use a series of matrices to help me solve this. Instead of using some of the methods that I would use with a system of linear equations like substitution or elimination, I'm going to put groups of two of these into matrices, use reduced row-echelon form, and find the intersection points. Those intersection points can be plugged into my constraint function, and the largest number that I get out of that will be the solution that I'm looking for. I already have that my I terms and my J terms and my constant terms are all in columns in standard form. So I'm just going to translate those into a matrix and do the reduced row echelon form operation. So I have 3, 2, negative 12. And then negative 3, 1, 12 will be my second row. So I will have a 2 by 3 augmented matrix. And really I have a 2 by 2 connected to a 2 by 1 here to make my augmented matrix. Now we're going to do RREF on this. Over here, I should get 1, 0, 0, 1, which is the identity matrix, and a number in the top and bottom here to be plugged into this function. Doing reduced row echelon form on this augmented matrix, I get the expected identity on the left and these numbers on the right. So this is my I and my J term that I will plug into this function. And when I simplify this, it will be, so I'll have 9 times negative 4 minus 6 times 0, which will give me negative 36. I have negative 36 here as one of my values. I potentially have 3 other points here, as long as we have 3 intersections that are here. So we are going to do the next set. I'll take the second two and create a matrix here. So I have 3, 1, 12 for this line here. Oh, this is negative. And then I'll have negative 3, 1, negative 6 for the second one. And again, we're going to do the reduced row echelon form on that. This time I get 1, negative a third, 0, 0, 0, 1. How do I interpret this? I didn't get the identity here. I did get some numbers that could potentially work here. But notice this bottom line. I have 0, 0, 1. If this is strictly an equality, I have potentially 0 plus 0 is equal to 1. Now, if this being that we have inequalities, if this is 0, 0 less than 1, this could potentially be a true statement. This line here, I had greater than here, and I had less than here. Notice that. What happens if I should graph this? If I graph this on the IJ axis, this first one here, I have J is going to be less than or equal to 3i plus 12. So up here at 12 is my intercept. And then I'm going to have 3 up and 1 over. So I have this positive here. And I am shading in the downward direction, so the lower half of the plane here. If I look at this one, I will have that j is greater than or equal to 3i minus 6. So I'm down here at negative 6, and then I'm going to go up 3 and over 1. So these are running parallel to each other. And this shades in the upper direction. So I have a feasible region. I have this double overlap right here, but there's no intersection between these lines. So this matrix is not going to reveal an I and a J because the I and J is interpreted as the intersection of the two lines. There is no intersection to be found with this because of having parallels. Now, some may have already realized that we were going to have parallels here because you recognize the pattern here. We have the same coefficients in front of J, and we have the same coefficients for our I values. When we bring those I's over this side and divide by this, that's your rise over run. We matching slopes, that means we have parallels. That's one of our postulates from geometry, the slopes of parallel lines postulate. So no intersection here, so we, as we would interpret this with an inequality, 0 plus 0 equals 1 is not true. There's no solution for this as an equality. And when we look at the inequality, we see that we have a feasible region with no intersection. Lastly, I want to look at this line and this line as a matrix and see if we can find an intersection using the reduced row echelon form. As we look at this one, we see the identity matrix here on the left. We see 0, 6, 0, -6 here. So we can plug this into our function. And then we are going to simplify this. And we get a positive 36. Of the two numbers that we had as results, I had a negative 36 and a positive 36. The maximum value that we are getting is positive 36. And that is from the point 0, negative 6. So this should be our maximum value for this system of equations with this constraint function. I like using matrices when I can to help simplify the algebraic work. I like to do the reduced row echelon form with the augmented matrices. I find these to be a really quick, effective way to do these problems. Hopefully this has been an interesting look at solving systems of linear inequalities with a constraint function. Cheerful calculations!